I'm Andrew Geraets, service technician with Environmental Tillage Systems, and we're going to go over how to set up the active implement guidance as far as setting up the application controller, verifying our receivers, as well as an auto calibration with the cart. So what we're going to do first is open up this ISO bus menu, then make sure we have our application controller pulled up. And so now, if the application controller was new, you'd have to put in an activation code, which would be added here. This one already has an activation code, so it's already unlocked. So after you originally unlock the application controller, and then you can go to your profile and set up your profile, where you'd put your machine name and then page over once you have a name picked. Make sure you check active implement guidance, not plow steer. Page over again. This is where we're going to add our GPS offsets. So you want to make sure that you hit edit, double check your tractor's offset for height, then edit your implement, make sure your height is right and your inline offsets and lateral offsets are in place. And you can check this box to automatically import dimensions from Equipment Manager if available. We're going to page over again. We want to make sure that we have our SCV3 valve selected, our analog 2N selected for our feedback sensor, and interface is JD proprietary. And then we want to make sure that our side shifting steering is unchecked. For error correction, we want to select implement 1 and leave row sense and speed control unchecked. For a row entry, we'll do engage all and make sure that the steering when work recording off is unchecked and row exit is unchecked. And then for enable implement line shifting, we'll leave that unchecked as well. For steering sensitivities, our starting point for default will be 3,000 for tracking sensitivity, 500 for accumulated sensitivity, and 1,000 for WAS sensitivity. Profile created successfully. And once we get to this page, we're just going to double check that everything is on there for our implement, valve, and make sure that our serial port 1 and 2, have GGA and 1 Hz, and make sure that they're both reading the same baud rate as well as NEMA. So those have both been verified that those are together. So after you have that, the setup is complete. So now, after that setup, we can go to our calibrations and do an auto calibration. Hit auto calibration. So now it's going to say start. We're going to make sure that the cart is centered, which it is. So that will be there. Then we're going to manually move the cart. We're going to set it all the way to max left, which is which way the tires are going to go. So that's max left. We're going to run this back the other way to max right. Set that. Now what we're going to do is, it says a valve, not an auto, so we're going to just going to click it forward. So that auto starts right there. So now what we're going to do is, we're going to get a little line picked up here. Okay. All right, so now on a guidance line, we're going to hit resume. And it's going to start going through and test itself. All right, status is active. Setup completed. So once you see that screen there, we're gonna just return out of it. And then it's all calibrated. Go back to status, kick it on, and there we are. Active upper guidance is running. That's it. All right. So now going through a little bit of the active implement guidance troubleshooting. So the first things we're gonna check is to make sure that our receivers as well as our application controller are being seen by the tractor. Under the ISO bus menu, we wanna verify that we can see the tractor receiver, the implement on the SoilWarrior, as well as this application controller. If any of these items are missing, be sure to check the cabling to make sure that they're properly connected, as well as you have power going to the application controller and to the rear receiver. If you do not have power going to those, it's important to maybe double check the power connectors in the tractor because a fuse may be blown. As long as everything shows up here, what we're going to do is also check each receiver to make sure that we have a chain link here, so that means that they're linked together. Double check our settings. Also double check our serial port to make sure that baud rates and output hertz match, as well as NEMA strings. We'll do this for both receivers, both implement and the main. After those have been checked, we're going to go through this application controller. Make sure that they're set up the same as well. They have the same baud rate. GGA selected at 1 Hz. We also want to make sure that we have an auto signal on our SCV3. If it has a check mark or any other thing, we might have to do a power cycle to get it back to go into auto like this. Once that's on, that's going, we're gonna go back to our status. And the status here can give you, if you're having any issues, if it doesn't see a feedback sensor voltage or things like that, use this status screen in order to do some troubleshooting that way as well. If you look here at this SCV3, it says that the valve is not ready. So when you begin, you want to make sure that you have your steering turned on the application controller, and then you want to do a quick detent on your SCV3 in order to engage it into auto. Once that's completed, the system will be ready to function.
Thanks for watching this service video. Call Environmental Tillage Systems with any questions or to order parts. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to view more videos. Find additional information on SoilWarrior.com.